Welcome back. A 7-year-old migrant girl has died in the custody of CBP agents. The girl and her father were part of a group of migrants crossing into New Mexico when they were detained last week. Just hours after she was detained, CBP agents said she began having seizures and had a temperature of 105 degrees. The girl was then airlifted to a hospital where she went into cardiac arrest and died. In a statement to the Washington Post, the CBP said this: "Our sincerest condolences go out to the family of the child. Border Patrol agents took every possible step to save the child's life under the most trying of circumstances. As fathers and mothers, brothers, sisters, we empathize with the loss of any child." So for more on this, I'm being joined now by immigration attorney Allen Orr. Allen, thanks for being with us today. So this, obviously, a tragic death. Anytime there is a death, it's sad. But what's made worse is that this is a little kid. It hits close to home for any parent. What type of legal rights does the father who just lost his child, what type of rights might he have here?
Well,
stateside.
I'm sure he's going to make a claim. The claim's going to be denied in some cases, right? Because it's sort of a Good Samaritan sort of case in that the government stepped in. The 163 migrants came over. They turned themselves over to CBP. CBP took them in at 10 p.m. And then apparently the seizures started around 6 o'clock in the morning. So that is sort of on the U.S.'s watch. So the question for me is, was it CBP or was it some private contractor working on behalf of CBP that failed to take the appropriate notice of this child? Because once you took them in at 10 o'clock, it seems like the first thing you would have offered is clothing, water, and food.
Makes sense.
In most cases, what they do is put them in these cold ice boxes to sort of unnerve them, to sort of keep them, you know, in pause, I guess, and then sort of interrogate them with regards to why they're coming to the United States. So a most inappropriate action, definitely actionable, and should never happen. It's a tragedy inside of a tragedy.
Now, a nonprofit organization in Texas called RICES is blaming what happened to this child on what they're calling a clogged immigration system for asylum seekers especially. Why isn't the federal government sending more judges to this area to help expedite these asylum cases? What's preventing that?
Nothing. And that's exactly why this is a tragedy inside of a tragedy, inside of a humanitarian issue for the United States, right? Just like we sent 4,000 troopers there, we could have sent judges, we could have sent processors. They're holding people at bay, processing maybe 150 cases a day, when that port processes 100,000 people every day.
Wow.
So it's just the United States making a decision to say we want to slow this down for no other reason.
The ACLU says that the girl's death is due to inhumane conditions, and I think you echo that sentiment and a culture of cruelty that we have. As an immigration attorney, have you seen any shift in sentiment towards immigrants, particularly with Central and South Americans recently, or has American sentiment largely been the same?
I think American sentiment has largely been the same, but they don't understand that these people are fleeing for their lives, and when you're fleeing for your lives, you're not looking for a door, you're getting out of a window or any way you can. In addition, in this case, when you're a 7-year-old, you don't really have the consciousness to say you're going into a country undocumented. You're just doing whatever your parents tell you to do, so that makes this even more of a tragedy. But the failure here is that we're not really addressing the issue that's happening that's causing these people to continually come here.
Right.
In addition, we're not addressing the issue of private prisons that are not controlled by the government, in which there is sexual abuse, inhumane treatment, and we're just going to see more of these cases, right? You can search the news to see that while this definitely was a tragedy, there are other tragedies that still exist of minors being raped, mm-hmm. beaten, mm-hmm. and misfed in these institutions that we're paying close to $140 for each individual a day.
And as you mentioned in the first question, we're still unsure if this was a contractor that this happened under, mm-hmm. Or if it was directly CBP. So we're obviously still investigating all the circumstances. But if long-term detention isn't the best method of handling the flux of migrants and detention to whether it's, you know, to hold them or to process them, if long-term detention isn't the answer, in your opinion, how should CBP handle this flux of migrants?
Right. I think you started originally with sort of saying what they need to do. They need to just process the cases, right? And then let the individuals in who could come in and who could not come in. And then we need to move away from private prisons, right? $140 a day is too much to keep an individual sort of there. And if it was $140, maybe a little less for a minor, why was there no food and water if it's $140 to have a bed for that person in a family unit. So the problem really is around what our focus is and what our goals are. Mm-hmm. Yes, our goal is to be a deterrent and to build a wall and to keep people from coming. But sort of building the wall and letting people die at the border when they're fleeing death is not the best way to do that. The best way to do that is to address the concerns in the home country and then to deal with the individuals that are here, make them well so they can return to safety. Not saying it's an open border, saying we are a humanitarian country, we will make sure you have food and water and a safe place to return to when you are removed.
Right, and let's deal with them in a humane, kind manner and
go
from there. Thank you so much for sharing your expertise with us, Allen Orr.
Hey YouTube, thanks for checking out our channel. We hope you enjoyed the video. We have tons of content for you just like this. For more of RT America's one-of-a-kind news and analysis, be sure to subscribe and never stop questioning more.